For millions of years, whales have played a crucial role in the ocean's ecosystem and the Earth's carbon cycle.
The inspiration we take is from the whales. Research has shown us the importance of whales and what they do and how they have been helping the climate problem for millennia.
Whales are climate engineers and their poo is rich in nutrients that fertilise the ocean. This stimulates the growth of phytoplankton, which capture an estimated 40% of all carbon dioxide produced. That's four times the amount of the Amazon rainforest.
When we think about the role of trees in terms of taking carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere and giving off oxygen when they photosynthesize, these tiny little phytoplankton are doing the same thing.
With the effects of whale hunting, we've had a devastating impact on the whale population. And because of this, we've also seen the effects on phytoplankton.
We're just starting to realise that. We took so many whales out of the system. We're hoping that we can simulate whale behaviour and sort of rebalance the ecology.
WhaleX are a team of scientists and engineers on a mission to prove that whale poo could help draw down carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and combat climate change. As part of that mission, they're taking part in XPRIZE Carbon Removal, a $100 million competition that's helping to accelerate scientifically viable, scalable and sustainable carbon removal solutions.
Through ocean nourishment, we aim to increase the productivity of the ocean by 1% to draw down a gigaton of carbon dioxide.
If you look at the ocean, it occupies about 70% of the surface area of the planet. This addresses drawing down those amounts of carbon dioxide using a natural process that occurs in the ocean.
So what whales do, as they feed, they dive down deep, then they come up to the surface ocean, and there they release very large nutrient plumes. And this fecal matter feeds the phytoplankton. It's exactly the right mix of nutrients the phytoplankton need to grow. It's like a vitamin injection for the ocean.
WhaleX plans to disperse artificial whale poo back into the oceans where they're depleted by using repurposed oil rigs, existing vessels or robotics to disperse the nutrients. They plan to stimulate the biological pump to feed phytoplankton. This phytoplankton will then feed all the marine life in the food chain before falling to the bottom of the ocean where it will be stored for over 100 years. But first, what is whale poo?
We looked at different whale discharges in the scientific papers that are actually breakdown of what do you typically find if you go looking for whale poop in the ocean.
There are researchers who actually go out and this is their role and they have actually got samples of whale feces. We are building experiments in units of whale poo. So we did a 300 litre experiment, a one whale poo experiment. From our satellite modelling, we've determined that the 300 litres that we put into the ocean sequestered around 1 tonne of CO2 to the bottom of the ocean.
Their roadmap to scaling up was to engineer a mesocosm.
What we have here is a mesocosm. That is a way of isolating a section of seawater which we will put nutrients into. Now the beauty of the mesocosm is that it's fully contained, so it doesn't mix with the surrounding ocean, and it would simulate exactly the conditions in the ocean, except we're enclosing that body of water so that we can monitor it. We're stepping from a laboratory scale experiment into the ocean. Because it's transparent, it has the benefit of the sunlight being able to get to the phytoplankton.
We're now building up to a 5 whale poo experiment, so 1,000 litres.
So we're going to get a dose of aquifer, 500 mils.
As phytoplankton grow and die, they will fall through this column of water to the bottom and we'll be able to draw off a sample.
This is to really validate our calculations in terms of how much carbon we can remove.
When we take seawater samples, we're looking for phytoplankton growth. So we want to see what type of organism are we growing. So we will look in the lab to make sure it's creating good phytoplankton that are healthy for the environment.
And to prevent any environmental risks or harmful algae blooms, the WhaleX team are taking their inspiration from the whales.
There has been no evidence in the 40 million years that whales have been roaming the ocean that they have ever caused a toxic algal bloom. And this is the lesson that we're taking from the whales, is that we aim to do this as a light touch, growing phytoplankton in pulses and having those pulses measured.
By trying to mimic what they were doing and putting some of these missing nutrients back into the areas of the ocean that were depleted, then we can start to regenerate the oceans and actually also sequester carbon dioxide at the same time.
One of the ways this carbon sequestration is measured is in the sediment core samples.
In the core sample, you can actually see the carbon that's sequestered, and it shows you the different rates of sequestration, and it tells you how much carbon has accumulated over years to centuries to millennia, and that carbon has stayed there.
To take the WhaleX idea to gigaton scale, we'd be looking at probably 300 sites around the world. Each site can remove 4 to 6 million tons of carbon dioxide per annum. Obviously, we want to take advantage of existing infrastructure, so it could be marine platforms, but it can also be ships that are traversing the ocean.
So we're looking at scaling the solution sustainably, and for the project we've been looking at whether we can repurpose an offshore rig, and then how can we make a whale poo solution on the rig, so using offshore wind and then looking at modular green ammonia.
But it's not just the climate the WhaleX team are addressing, they're also rewilding the oceans and helping to restore the ocean biodiversity and all marine life that depend on whales and phytoplankton. Whales have an enormous influence on the planet's atmosphere, and the value of them in the oceans and on the Earth is much greater than we ever imagined.
The role of WhaleX in nourishing the ocean naturally provides productivity for whales to grow. So the ultimate aim is for the whales to regrow, but whales take 100 years to reach their full lifetime. So by simulating what whales do, by making the oceans more productive, the ultimate aim is to help the whales grow and regrow their populations.
To learn more about XPRIZE Carbon Removal, head to xprize.org/carbonremoval.